All right. We are playing Legend of Zelda: Link to the Past.
Yes, welcome to the premiere episode of Game Neglect, where we take a look at games we've missed for various reasons. Now, Steve, why did you miss A Link to the Past?
I was 2 when it came out.
You were 2.
Yes. And then I was too busy playing games like Crash Bandicoot and Final Fantasy when I was a child.
Okay, so you were just too young for A Link to the Past.
And never had a Super Nintendo until I became an adult.
You couldn't have borrowed one of your friends?
I didn't realize he had one. He only lived around the corner.
So we have to defeat Aghanim. He has done something to the other missing girls.
He's kidnapping girls.
Yeah, that's pretty sketchy.
This game wouldn't fly in 2017 America.
I mean, it would. I'm sure there's stuff on TV of girls getting kidnapped, like the Special Victims Unit. Is your uncle? He's gotta go save the day? Or is that your dad?
I don't know.
You got the lamp.
I have a lamp.
It was a dark and stormy night.
Probably going the wrong way.
I think you're going the right way.
Hey, mister, will you let me in the castle? No. So you watch any Iron Fist yet?
I did. I'm liking it. It's not as much fighting as I thought it would be, though.
Yeah? The true story of Joe Colombo?
Huh. First impressions of this fine game? Graphics?
Graphics are pretty good for the time.
How's your purple hair?
It's good.
You like it? You don't hate it?
Dyed my hair purple.
I don't know if you could pull it off.
I probably could. Hey, buddy.
Nothing so far looks like ugly or a bad sprite.
No. You know, Super NES aged pretty well. Not like the other systems.
It's N64, PlayStation 1 that really start to look bad.
It's true. The 64 bits just don't hold up.
So, what other Zelda games have you missed?
Pretty much everything except Majora's Mask.
Just Majora's Mask you've played?
I've only played Majora's Mask.
Now, have you 100% Majora's Mask?
No, I don't remember how far.
Or at least gotten all the masks.
I don't even think I finished it.
Oh, you did not? Okay.
I don't remember. It's like that odd period of when we had a 64 before my brother decided we no longer needed a 64.
Mm-hmm. So you did for a little while have a Nintendo 64?
Yes.
And now you have one again.
Now I have one again.
That we cleaned out.
And it's nice. Pikachu colored.
Pikachu colored? So yes. That would be just yellow.
It's just yellow. It's not yellow and blue.
Just yellow. That's just a normal shaped Pikachu color.
Yeah.
Pikachu shade.
I actually murdered a Pikachu and put it on the 64.
So it's like felt.
It's felt, yes. We between the felt 64. Well, that's much easier than actually fighting them.
You're getting your butt kicked. This is the first dungeon.
Yeah, I noticed. He locked me into the bridge. And was like, you shall now pass. Menu. Hit the wrong buttons.
So I guess there wouldn't be much point in asking you your favorite Zelda game, unless you've tried enough to really...
Nope, I wouldn't really have an answer for you.
Okay.
Though, I do want to try Breath of the Wild at some point.
Yeah, it is... A big departure from traditional Zelda. Did you get a key? Oh, then you gotta kill him. Excellent. Looks promising. Key.
But I feel like Breath of the Wild, like I would never venture to the end of the story.
Why did you... Oh, the lamp.
The lamp? Does a genie come out of it?
Hello?
Hello?
The dog's barking at me like I haven't been... Coming here every Sunday for the last 2 years.
Yep.
And we're outside. What you playing?
Welcome.
Zelda?
Welcome to the first episode of Gamer Claim on YouTube.
Oh, shit. I guess, should I just shut up or should I be my witting, witty,
you can be your witting, witty, charming self.
Yeah. You my witting self, too.
You can introduce yourself to our no fans as well.
Oh, cool.
Stand a little bit over here, so you're in the microphone's direction.
Oh, I'm in the microphone zone?
Yeah.
I'm in the phone zone?
And if Steve holds right here, I'll grab your chair.
Sweet. He's always wanted to be in the phone zone before. No, I had considering you're just rescuing Princess Zelda right now. I gathered that. Alright, so I'm Sean. Hi, nobody. Maybe in 5 years there'll be like 12 fans and they'll be like, oh, hey.
Where'd that Sean guy go?
Yeah.
So what we do, this is game neglect.
Uh-huh.
So any games we've neglected to play or missed out on, we're going to highlight.
Oh, man, that's a brilliant idea. There's so many games I've just been sitting on and like... The other thing is like, I got nothing to play, and you get a stack of 12 games you've never... So yeah, this is basically for when you get the stack of 12 games, and whenever you have nothing to play, you don't even consider those 12 games, even though every time you look at that 12 stack of 12 games, you're like, man, I gotta play these games.
Yes, exactly.
But then you never do.
But then you never do, yeah.
And the years go by.
And here we are.
And here we are. But I did not have a Super Nintendo growing up, so I missed this.
Oh, shit. I mean, I did have a Super Nintendo, and I still miss this, so, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, and I did play it years and years later, but...
So you have played it now?
Yeah.
And beaten it?
Actually, no.
Run away! So I didn't pay attention to what she said?
She said, take me to Sahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrahasrah Yes. I mean, if you want, I guess you could just go sit on the throne and proclaim yourself the king of Hyrule, but I don't really think anyone's going to listen to you, so...
Because I'm sure some bad guy's doing that right now, right?
That's a little unfortunate that they're underneath you. underneath the bridge.
I'm pretty sure there's still another guy down there. Yeah, there he is.
There he is.
Hey, guys. Aww.
There's a secret passage in the throne room that leads to the sanctuary. Thanks, Steve.
Oh. So you do have to go to the throne to proclaim yourself king of Hyrule.
Yeah.
Is the old man there?
Not yet.
You know, come to think of it, stuff doesn't often turn out well for Link.
Not usually.
Yeah.
Things usually go way downhill before they go uphill.
No, like, even at the end, like, he doesn't really,
Oh, they're usually just kind of like, thanks.
What'd they want you to do?
As a decorative shelf?
You said light something on fire.
Maybe one of those tapestries? I don't remember. Again, it's been a while.
Nope.
Open all those. Other side.
Even if you do get them all open, you need to light something on fire. You can't. You're pulling out of magic and Hyrule is doomed now.
Oh, that's not it.
All right. That one.
Swing, swing, swing.
I mean, I'm trying to think about it, right? Like, typically he just kind of saves the day and then goes back to doing whatever he was doing beforehand.
Well, a lot of the time his, like, companion the whole time just up and ditches him and gets lost in another dimension.
Yeah, well, I was thinking, this is why we read when people talk, by the way. Like, alright, Ocarina of Time.
Good.
Navi leaves, right? And then she comes back. Well, no, you spend the whole point that Majora's Mask happens is because Link's like, where's my fairy?
Yeah.
And I don't even think you find her at the end of Majora's Mask, do you? I don't know. I hate Majora's Mask, so.
You hate Majora's Mask?
Yeah, I know. A lot of people hate me for saying that. I can can't stand the repetition, man.
Well, you don't like time travel.
No, I hate time travel. It's a terrible writing implement.
She said there's an old man. Look, there's a secret passage in the throne room that leads to the sanctuary. I'm sure the old man there will help us.
Yeah, in the sanctuary is the old man. In the throne room is a secret passage to the sanctuary where the old man lives. And when you walked here, she said something about... Oh, there we go.
Oh, can you push it from the side?
Oh, you think you just gotta push it, yeah.
Help me push it from the left, yep.
That's the other left.
I was thinking stage left, Sean.
Okay, that's fair.
Did she say that the first time? Because I didn't even remember her talking.
She 100% said that last time. Mm.
Squeak, squeak.
Good thing you got magic. Oh, there it is.
Squeak, squeak. That's promising. So, yeah.
So what does happen at the end of Majora's Mask? Can you just, like, leave?
Well, you stop the apocalypse.
Yes. In this weird parallel dimension.
And you make friends with the Skull Kid, because that's all he wanted.
Great. And you don't find Navi?
I can't really recall.
I'm gonna say no.
Well, you fell in a giant hole in the beginning, right?
Didn't you just get lost in the woods?
And then you fall into, like, this trunk.
Oh, yeah. And then the Skull Kid finds you, turns into a Deku Kid, and you're like, ah, shit. I did dig the transforming aspect of that.
Yeah, that was fun. Be a Goron for a little while?
Yeah.
What other games can you be a Goron? Hyrule Warriors.
Yeah, Hyrule Warriors, you can be Darunia.
That's it.
Alright, light a torch, because it's killing me that you're not. Thank you.
I was actually just using Pokemon's flash technique.
Just not using flash and just walking through the cave?
Yeah.
God, I'm so glad HMs are gone.
Right?
Yeah.
That was our childhood, though. Shouldn't some generation have to suffer through that?
Shouldn't everyone have to suffer because we did?
Yes.
No, Josh. That's not sound logic.
We'll make them stronger gamers for it.
That's true. That is sound logic.
Alright, I can grant that.
You won't get the kids that, like, fail playing Dark Souls and then want to return it. for that stupid life.
Oh, God. Did you get a lot of people at work returning Dark Souls because it was too hard?
Yes. I would just laugh at them.
Good.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, my girlfriend's little cousin... Oh, I guess he's not so little anymore.
That means
he's probably like 12, maybe 13 now. He liked Demon Souls and did not like Dark Souls, like it was too hard, and, which is weird because I don't like Demon Souls, but I love the shit out of Dark Souls.
I'm pretty sure that's the opposite of how it's supposed to be, too.
Did you even?
Yeah. And so he asked me, like, it's just so hard, I don't know what to do. And for the life of me, I could not think of a single thing to say except for just get good.
Get good.
Just get good. That's all you have to do. I felt so bad because I'm trying to be helpful. I like this kid. But all I can think of is get good.
Get good.
Yeah. Just don't suck. Suck less.
Steve, did you even talk to your uncle, father?
He died.
Yeah, but he says stuff. Just pull the switch over there.
Is it I'm a failure because I died?
No, I think it's like take this shield and sword and...
And you've always been a disappointment to me, son, nephew.
You don't listen.
Yeah. These are my last words, but no one will know them because you're not fucking listening to them.
Are you safe? Is this you doing, Steve?
He doesn't know my name.
Because you live like a mile away from him.
Not even. Probably like a stone's throw.
Yeah, and there's like three people in this town. And guards. Lots of guards.
Where did the guards
live? Easily fooled guards.
If we release seals of the seven men before it is too late, destroy the wizard before he destroys all of Hyrule. You can do it. You can. I sense.
He just drops dead right there.
The legendary Master Sword.
What's that? I've never heard of that before.
Never heard of it. Had there been a Master Sword before this? Like, called the Master Sword?
Was there a Master Sword in Link's Adventure?
Or Zelda?
No, it was just the Magic Sword, wasn't it?
Hey, let me see. They're rolling booklets.
Oh, shit. You got them right here.
The actual ones are down further.
This is all Link in the Past.
Yeah, hand me that whole stack.
Oh, I'll look through one. You look through the other one.
I think they're towards the bottom.
Oh, man. Shadows of the Empire.
I have that.
That game sucked. I love the shit out of it.
We'll play that.
Like, I did play it a lot, and boy, looking back, was it garbage. It was, like, hot garbage. What the hell is Body Harvest?
An N64 game.
I gathered that.
Don't worry, I think we've all played garbage games.
That's it, yeah. We'll move to the past again.
That's what we need.
Oh, I thought you were looking for,
Oh, we can look for the others,
the
too.
The NES one, yeah.
I'm not sure those are there. Alright, according to this game booklet, the Master Sword is mostly silver with a spot of red and yellow.
And every cosplayer has one.
And they're purple.
Well, blue.
Well, yeah, blue or purple. But the screen definitely has it the same color.
Yeah. Well, it could just be any old sword.
With an eye on it? Like a blinking eye?
Let's see. Appearances of the Master Sword. Link to the Past, Ocarina of Time, Oracle of Ages, and Seasons, Four Swords, Wind Waker, Five Princess, Skyward Sword, Link Between Worlds, Breath of the Wild. Yeah, this is the first time the Master Sword ever
showed up. So this is the first Master Sword.
Yep. Yeah, I know about jack shit about Zelda 2, because talking about games that are hot garbage, that game is rancid, filthy garbage.
Maybe you just weren't good enough at it.
I mean, that's entirely possible, but I don't think so. It's got a lot of stuff that's like, magically know to go to this location, and
yes,
that's how you progress.
That I hear.
Yeah. You know, the actual, like, gameplay in the dungeons seems fine, but the fact that you can only advance by sort of divining from the spirits or the Nintendo Power Hotline where you're supposed to go?
Yes.
It's a bit of a problem.
That's a mistake. But, I mean, a lot of this game could be looked at the same way.
I think that's kind of why I, like, never beat this game.
If you don't know exactly where to go, or you weren't listening, then you'll miss it.
I got a mushroom.
Smells like sweet rotten fruit.
I really
you can give this to anyone who wants it.
It smells like sweat. I'm like, sweat, oh, great.
Sweat and rotten fruit.
I got a sweaty fruit room. Just what I've always wanted. Can't wait to show my uncle, Dad.
Oh, wait, he's dead.
Oh, shit, yeah.
Steve, are you going to die?
He might die. He's going to be like a little ladybug. He's going to fly out one of these branches and murder him.
There's no quid.
Look at all the little delightful woodland creatures.
It is your uncle.
I thought it was your uncle.
Confirmed. I just haven't had a chance to see any text confirming that.
Right.
There's a lot of missing notes on there.
Hey, Hillian script.
Yeah.
It actually doesn't look that different from the Hillian script they use nowadays. I don't think so. I could be wrong.
You're not going to take that?
I tried.
He's not worthy yet. See?
Ah.
Yeah. Did it actually budge? Because that would have been pretty cool. I don't think it did.
You just wanted it to?
Don't kill the woodwind critters.
I need some life.
Oh.
I'm pretty sure...
You could probably get that other shittier sword.
I'm pretty sure everyone playing Breath of the Wild kills a lot of innocent creatures.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
For everyone who is currently playing Breath of the Wild, the Hinox dates all the way back to at least A Link to the Past.
What's the Hinox?
The giant Cyclops.
Oh.
I guess I can't kill this guy.
I think he's a thief and he just steals stuff from you. I could be wrong about
Leave
that.
Leave him there. Snapdragons, Helmasaurs, Wizrobes, oh my.
Well, Wizrobes were definitely in the first Zelda.
Yeah, but were they called that?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Boy, everyone watching the video is going to love this classic Zelda low health beeping.
Yeah, Steve, you got to get some health.
I'm working on it.
Before you lose the two fans that you gained 3 minutes ago. Oh.
They're gone.
Yep.
They're gone.
That's it.
They're going to subscribe after this noise goes away. Where you're going in a circle, Steve.
I mean,
you've got to go north. There's some bushes. Chop the bushes.
I mean, in theory, you are looking for the Master Sword, right? And you did find it. You just can't get it.
Was he told to directly seek out the Master Sword, or was he told to go somewhere else first?
I don't know. When he picked up the shitty sword, he's like, this is it! It's the Master Sword! Like, oh no, it's just some shitty plastic.
Painted white.
I'm sure it wasn't plastic.
It was plastic.
Alright, I'm just gonna tell him where to go.
So what's up next on the docket for you to play that you've been ignoring?
Me?
Yeah.
My first game, I believe, is going to be Paper Mario.
Oh man, that game's good.
Yeah. I have never played.
Pretty sure you could just talk to that person. Mario. Or just ignore them, that's fine.
Oh, I thought.
I haven't talked to anyone in 10 years, but. Hey, look, someone to talk to! Oh.
Gang of Thieves.
Wait, one of my ex members. He's giving you vital information!
Fine.
Staying at the entrance of the desert. Alright, never mind.
I don't even know where the desert is.
Can we just get some help?
I'm trying.
Just die then.
There he goes.
There you go.
Thank you.
But look.
Meet the Elder of the Village and get the Master Sword. So we're going to the village.
Ah, yes, you gotta go to the village first and then get the Master Sword. So you go up to the Master Sword, it's like, have you met the Elder yet? No?
Well, why are you here?
Yeah, then get the hell out!
You have no respect for your elders. I'm not going to cut anything for you.
Yeah, I heard from the ghost of your dad uncle that you didn't even listen to his last dying words.
I'm going to put butter back together.
I'm guessing it's not in the cemetery?
Yes, this is where the elder lives.
Yeah, they live in the cemetery, the entire village.
It's just to save time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everyone just sleeps in open graves, and then if they die in their sleep, they're like, alright, just throw the dirt on him and we're good.
Yeah.
That's what we do in my family.
Yeah.
There's a cave.
You know, that actually reminds me of this big gripe that my brother has, and it's a good point about Journey to the Center of the Earth.
Yeah.
Is the guy's going to the center of the Earth because his brother, right, was going on this expedition, and he's like, there's something down there, I'm going to find it, and he never came back. So they find this, like, hut and a grave, and, like, he's like, this is my brother's grave.
Who buried him?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who? Wow, how? So, like, And they even put it in the movie with Brendan Fraser. Like, maybe they'll fix it. No.
Huh.
No, they didn't.
They repeated the mistake.
Yeah, he carved his own tombstone, set it down, died in place, is
well,
what we figured.
What if he built, like, something out of reeds, and then the reeds would rot and drop the dirt on him, and he was sleeping under there?
See, that's what... Oh, yeah. Oh, so he was sleeping, he's like, it's about time to die, I guess I'll just smother myself in dirt and call it a day.
No, because it's holding... The reeds are holding the dirt up above,
right?
Right,
right, right.
So then he dies.
Yeah.
And then the reeds are rotting.
Eventually they
rot. Eventually it falls through.
Yeah.
It's like the game with the marbles and the sticks.
Oh, not Spelunk. That's cave diving. I feel like it's something. God, what the hell is that? It's something Unk. It's gotta be.
Kerplunk.
Kerplunk, there it is. Yeah, I remember that game. We figured that it was possible, actually, that he had tied, like, a rope to his waist, right? And he knew, he was like, well, I'm gonna die soon, so I'm just gonna hang around this empty grave I dug. And he had the tombstone break and everything. So when he eventually fell backwards into the grave upon his, like, sudden death, it pulled, like, a quick release for the dirt that was hanging in, like, the canopy above him.
Uh-huh.
So he hit the ground, and then the dirt hit him, and then he's buried, and he's good. He's like, oh, I gotta have a grave, because otherwise I'm automized, some uncivilized savage. And I would have liked, like, two paragraphs in the book dedicated to explaining the way in which this man buried himself after his own death. But, you know...
Or during his own death.
Yeah. At the exact moment of his death. We can't always get what we want.
We could try sometimes.
We just might find.
Get what you need.
But usually not.
Nope. That's not the village.
Sure, it'd be good if I remembered how to get anywhere in this game.
Isn't it just... Don't you have a map? I'm pretty sure you just go east.
Yeah, actually, that's probably correct.
Press start. Press select.
Instead of start. Nope. All right.
Well, that's how we're going to save.
There we are.
There it is. Now, how do you work it? So you're there. You want to get all the way down and left.
As west, then, yeah. There we go. And that's where you got to go.
With that handy-dandy blinking X. So, yeah,
cross
that bridge.
Yeah, so just cross that bridge and go in a straight line west.
All right, we got this. We are three grown men.
It's 10 minutes later.
And we can handle...
Where the hell are we supposed to go? Hang on, what is that totally conspicuous patch of grass that has an arrow pointing to the right? Go back. Go back. And down. Alright, that doesn't seem... Oh, you don't have,
you
like, the flippers
the Pegasus
yet, right?
Boots.
Is that
in this
game? Flippers.
Maybe the flippers. Maybe there's something there.
Yeah,
well. It looked like there was another spot on the other side you could jump.
Yeah.
Yay!
Use that 10 minutes ago.
Yeah, we could have.
Alright, so now we know where to go. I'm not going to bother looking up, even though I just found one.
And Steve's going to read the text so that he knows what to do next.
No,
nope,
not.
Overrated.
Alright. Nice.
I was elected to lead, not to read, Sean.
I can't argue with that.
You know, it was right there.
Yeah.
If you just said, hey, it's down from my house.
Yeah. Oh, this is an iconic song.
That's true.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, I mean, I don't quote me on this, but I think, and I could be wrong, I think Steve is reading right now.
Is it? Because I'm not. Yeah. I was completely spaced out.
I caught something was sleeping. And that was it. And she didn't know where he was, that the wizard took the elder.
Uh-huh.
Which seems like you have one, you know, one job as a village is to protect the elder.
Hide out for a gang of thieves.
I presume that was his wife, so... He's probably like, I'm going out to the bar to get a drink. And she's like, all right, see you tomorrow when you stumble in drunk, like always.
Yeah.
Jerk.
Oh, this is a pushing puzzle.
Can Steve do it?
Answer is no.
There's also a bomb up there on the top of the wall.
Right here.
Yeah, but you don't have any bombs. Push that one down. Push that one left.
It's like...
Push that one. That one down. Yeah.
This one?
Yeah. Now push that one left. Now push that one down.
I thought we weren't bothering Steve. We're gonna let him learn on it.
Oh, sorry. You're right.
You can do it. I believe in you. I mean, I only a little bit believe in you. But but part of me does believe in you.
I don't.
Alright. Well, at least one of us kind of believes in you.
I knew he'd do it.
Alright.
Excellent.
Let's take out our handy dandy map.
It's a little
still saying in. Go talk to the elder that's not here. Good.
Let's go double check on what you said.
Let's all read it this time.
Alright.
The elder. Oh, no one. Has seen him since the wizard began collecting victims. What, Master Sword? Well, I don't remember the details exactly, but... Long ago, a prosperous people known as the Hylia inhabited this land. Legend tells of many treasures that the Hylia hid throughout the land. The Master Sword, a mighty blade forged against those with evil hearts, is one of... them. People say that now it sleeps deep in the forest. Do you understand the legend?
Nope.
Anyway, look for the elder. There must be someone in the village who knows where he is.
Just go harass everyone in
town. Yeah, we gotta talk to everyone.
Jump. It's a pretty empty village.
Well, I mean, the wizard kidnapped everybody, so, you know.
I think the wizard was... Wasn't the wizard only kidnapping maidens?
Well, apparently he kidnapped...
And old men.
He kidnapped the elder. I totally hit no on that, and I bought it anyway.
Maybe it was like, no, yeah, and yeah, no. And you just picked no, yeah, which means yes.
Uh-oh. She turned you in.
Yeah.
To the brilliant guard that can't figure out a bush.
Well, he's like, he's green, and this is green, so this is probably part of him.
Yeah, go kick her ass, yeah.
I can't.
Maybe. Ah, she locked the door.
Yeah. Well, next time you see her, she's dead meat.
I think Johnny Cash sang a song about Link being a wanted man.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm pretty sure there's several songs about wanted men of his. Don't even.
Question of the day, what's the first time you were killed by cuckoos?
Lon Lon Ranch, Ocarina of Time.
Lon Lon Ranch?
Yeah.
Make them mad.
Is there a chicken under that pot?
I think this is a chicken running into the pot, and as soon as he picked it up, it...
Oh, it could move into that spot?
It went the rest of the way, yeah. If you insist. I mean, as soon as you run out, it'll be fine, I guess.
Do they do it inside?
That's a good question.
Do they do it in this version?
I'm pretty sure
they definitely do it in this game. I think it might take a really long time. You could totally bomb that wall on the right if you had bombs.
Can I light them on fire?
Nope. Get some nice roast chicken. It's another nice touch that if you kill like a warthog or something in Breath of the Wild with a...
Up. That guy's suspicious.
Yep. With fire. They give you cooked food.
Oh, really?
Yeah. If only real life worked like that.
Yeah.
Save a lot on them, like, the production industry.
Huh. You just poke a cow with, like, fire and have hamburgers?
Just kind of drop a bunch of pigs in, like, through a bonfire, and then bacon falls out the bottom.
Yeah.
That'd be great.
That's how it works.
That's pretty much how it works.
Apparently Zora can turn people into fish.
That's not nice.
I mean...
Up until...
Unless you've always wanted to be a fish.
Up until, I bet you have to sneak up on him. Up until, Not Link to the Past. What's the N64?
Ocarina of Time.
Yeah, up until Ocarina of Time, the Zora were bad guys, weren't they?
Yeah, they retconned it between the Ocean Zora or the Sea Zora or something and the River Zora.
River Zora, okay.
Yeah, so, and all the bad Zoras are the River Zora.
River Zora are bad, okay. Yeah.
And then in Wind Waker, the bird people, for some reason...
Is that where we're going now?
Yeah, that X right there.
What'd they tell us?
That the grandfather is hiding past the castle.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
So the bad people won't find him.
All right. Let's head off.
Yeah. So after the world was flooded with water, and you would think the Zora would be like, this is great!
Yep.
They evolved into bird people for some reason.
For no reason at all.
Yeah. Why? And yet Gorons still exist, who live in caves and eat dirt.
Yep.
Or, I'm sorry, rocks.
I can't remember the Zoran Gorons.
There's a couple. They're in, like, bucket hats and Hawaiian shirts and stuff.
Wouldn't they still... Oh, okay. That rings a bell.
Yeah.
Wouldn't they still just live in Death Mountain? That Death Mountain would be one of the mountains that is an island.
Yeah, but I don't think, actually, you ever go to Death Mountain or an equivalent in Wind Waker.
I seem to,
there's a volcano, but it's like a little thing.
Okay.
Like, pretty sure. This is like one of those islands you go to that's kind of like its own. Kind of, I guess. Wind Waker kind of had, like, you know, the shrines in Breath of the Wild.
Yeah.
There were a lot of islands that are just like, figure out the puzzle that is this island. Alright. Yep. It's not a whole dungeon, but it's a thing.
Yeah, it's a thing for you to do. I haven't played that game since it came out.
That game was really good.
And have you played Minish Cap?
No, I have not. I've heard it's good. I didn't think it was going to actually be very good, so I never picked it up.
Well, you can play that one if you want on the series.
Oh, maybe.
You're going the right way.
You're going the right way.
All right, we got this.
I read and I learned stuff.
And now we're going to implement that stuff.
All right. Steve's advancing to a third grade education right now. Soon, he may, like, unlock the secrets of context clues.
He's a good gamer. I don't know why he's, rushing through this.
I don't like to read things. I like to learn things on my own.
Okay.
You're playing the wrong game.
Oh, you're close. There it is. Alright,
it's cool. Pretty close.
Hey, old guy.
Here I am.
Hey.
I am indeed... Sahasrala?
Yeah.
Guy.
That's how I would pronounce that. Could have made that a little easier.
How are you one descendant of seven wise men?
Well, they all interlinked together.
They all had, children. So if, like, the seven wise men were alive, like, 200 years ago...
Had a mix of daughters and sons, and they had, like, a narrowing...
Oh, no, he didn't say he's the only descendant. He just said he's a descendant.
Yes, but he's related to all seven of them.
Oh.
Otherwise, he's a descendant of a wise man.
Maybe they just lived in one village and all their children eventually, you know...
Commingled?
Commingled down the line until they was, you know...
Yeah. Okay.
Genetically equal to all seven wise men.
Keep the bloodline pure and all that.
Yeah. That's why I inherited the baldness.
I was born like this. Yeah, he lives in a very ominous little shack.
You know, he could totally help me by giving me all the stuff like that he can originally, and then let me go find the sword.
Where are we headed?
That's somewhere with the Pendant of Courage. Oh, right over there. All
right.
Oh, you got to get all three of those. Yeah, it's the get the three things and then get the seven or eight things.
Yep. The patented put your back to the enemy style.
Yeah, Steve doesn't like to look at Armos when he fights them. They don't deserve it. They're ugly.
You're going to have to get up there somehow. That probably is the way because it's blocked off. Stupid chess piece. There we go.
Hey,
hop down there.
Or run away from the Armos. I mean, whatever works. But definitely don't look at him.
Hey, it's worked twice.
Three times now, I think.
No, the other one I was staring at. and quick jabbing like this.
Yeah, I mean, that's garbage. That obviously didn't work. Never do that again.
He has real trouble with the knights.
They actually are a pain in the ass.
With the shield?
Yeah.
He's blocking the staircase.
Hey.
There you go.
It's like he doesn't want me to use the stairs.
I mean, almost like he was assigned to make sure that no strange green-clad boys run into these...
With pink hair.
Cloud boys?
Cloud boys?
Cloud boys.
Is that what you said?
No, strange green-clad boys.
Green-clad.
Yeah, I guess we can call him a cloud boy, too, if cloud you really boy? Want to.
That's what? Definitely a pressure play right there.
No, you're wrong. That's stupid.
What kind of enemies are those?
Anemones.
Ah...
Oh.
Boulders.
Do I go that way?
Probably.
Always go towards sudden death. Oh! Not that. Not death that sudden. Less sudden death.
It's like AC/DC up in here. except they're not really bouncing.
No.
And so it's just like, it's similar to. It's not quite there. Yeah. Stalfos. No, they're Stalfos.
Oh, yeah. They're jumping into the ass, isn't it?
Why would a skeleton be so keen on jumping?
They are... They don't have all that dumb flesh to weigh them down anymore.
Yeah, but, I mean, they don't have all that much flesh to generate momentum, either.
I mean, by all means, they shouldn't be able to move, but the world is full of magic, Josh, and if a skeleton wants to jump, who am I to say they can't jump?
I'm just saying, why do they like it so much?
Because they can. I mean, let's say you were on the ground, dead for about 50 years, right, and all your friends rotted away, and suddenly this green kid shows up, and now you're back alive. Would you not jump for joy?
At seeing a child?
Like, just suddenly, you have come back to life. And you are now animated bones. And you see the rest of your animated bone friends.
Someone's trying to kill you.
Yeah, someone's trying to kill you. Would you not want to just, like, get away and jump and... Like, immediately, like, oh man, I'm alive! Yeah! And then, die. As this kid's trying to kill you, you know...
I need a big key. Is the big key in the big treasure chest?
That's bullshit. There's no way.
Eh, it's locked.
Okay, it's the opposite of that.
Okay, you were right.
Yeah, I wish I had a point with all that I was saying, but I sure didn't.
Yeah. I figured I'd let you off the hook with that one. So do you think that's an issue with the game? Being able to go under the thing, or is that something cool?
It would be nicer if while you were under it, they turned it transparent so you could see where the hell you're going.
Yeah, that would be. You better run.
Do 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 run in a circle.
Square.
I do think there are some perspective issues with this game sometimes. With, like, things being on different levels.
Okay.
I think overall, though, like, the hitboxes are, like... Like, if a skeleton jumps and, like, the sprite looks like it's next to you, but he's actually, like, 2 feet south from you, I think you can still hit him. Which doesn't make much sense, but is easier on you.
Yeah, it's more forgiving.
Yeah.
What, I paused you?
Do you want me to go upstairs and see who's here?
Oh, we're at well past a half hour, so we can call it.
Alright.
As soon as they shut up. And you can save and quit. We did it.
Alright. I mean, I could be entirely wrong about that perspective thing, and maybe you can't hit them when they're jumping next to you, but hey!
You know? It's fine.
Stop taking out, kids. I'm coming down.
Aw, man.
Hurry, Josh. Get off me.
Hurry,
let
Josh.
Me finish putting my pants back on. Oh, just in time. I made it.
Tacos.
All right, we're going to sign out here.
Oh, no! I was going to say, can I lick it?
Did you save?
Yeah.
Oh, we didn't say goodbye. Wait, it's fine.
I guess you could just say goodbye now. This is saying goodbye.
Yep. Everyone, this is Dan, and thanks for watching.
Now that he's here, we gotta go.
Oops.
We can't have four people here.